Notice on the outside, it's an decadent sheet church, actually, that's the 15th century, that's the decadent sheet. Then, on top of the highest peak of mount, that's exactly what the book tells us. He went up to the Mount of Olives after 40 days from his function, and his and when he reached to the peak, he started to ascend up to heaven. People were looking at him up to heaven and thinking, damn. Now, why did we determine that this is the point? This is the spot. Here, they found within the center of this part the 2 footprints carved in the bed. Now, many people would come in and say, oh, when Jesus went to heaven, it was so powerful. His feet sank in the bedrock, went up to heaven. It's not the matrix. It's not. I'll tell you more, what is the logic explanation about the 2 footprints? Jesus always said, I shall come back again. We still expect the Messiah to come back, right? Now, when somebody will leave from a place that you don't know where it is or what it is, not an airport, it's a mountain. Now, you want to keep a reference of this particular place because you expect him to come back to the same place. So what did they do? They simply carved 2 footprints at the spot where they seen him ascending up to heaven. And that's exactly what happened. Carved by those who witnessed that ascension. Now, the place continued to serve as a church in the Byzantine period. The outside part was covered, but the inside, the center part, was not covered. Why is that? Because they wanted pilgrims to come in, look at the 2 footprints, and then look up towards heaven where he ascended. It's like one time, you know, in Texas, right? They don't speak English, you want to explain it. Ascension, where Jesus went to heaven to do a miracle. Here, Jesus. Anybody wants the panoramic
picture? But a dollar, if you have any way out. $1 the poster.
I'll take 2 of them on the way out.
Okay. And also had a good book in English for $10. $10 the book.
Don't worry about it. I don't need it.
Do you want here? No. Sure. Sure. Actually, one of the 2 footprints when the place was converted to a mosque have been chopped out of the bedrock. Unfortunately, we found that piece in a mosque in Turkey dedicated to be the footprint of Muhammad. It's that same one. The second one, you can see partial parts of it. It's over here. You can see this part of the picture over here. The second one used to be over here. So it's like this. So if you look at this very clearly, you can see. But unfortunately, yeah, it's a stone. People coming in, it's not something where it should be seen. But everybody comes in, wipe it out, and starts to. That's where the 2 footprints were, and many of those pilgrims for a long time drawn it, gave us a very good idea of life and happens. Friends, look at this time. You see the depression here? Where does that come from? Actually, from the entrance, because this is where the holy water used to be. Many of the churches, they didn't have the baptismal fountain. What they used to do is sprinkle water on the people to baptize them. And that was chopped by the Romans, brought over here, creating the direction of prayer towards the temple. But they kept the name of the mosque of the ascension of Prophet Isa. Who's Isa in Arabic? Jesus. They believe in him as a died. Not that he was crucified somewhere. It looked like him, he's not the son of God, but he's a prophet, so they kept it as a mosque dedicated to the prophet. And this is where the Imam would be leading the prayer to his Maker on the rock that used to be in the Baptist area, outside the church. Different pictures, guys, and you outside the church.